Introduction.
Seni Saraki, the co-producer of the Black Panther Wakanda Forever soundtrack. And happy to be here.
Awesome. So first off, that's a big title, but I'm coming back to that. I wanted to ask, you know, what does this mean for the entertainment business in Africa, where we're seeing an African premiere of a Hollywood studio project?
I think it's amazing, and I think it's very intentional, you know, like Ryan, this is something Ryan really wanted to do. Like when he came to Lagos for the first time to record in May, he said, oh, like I want to come back and do a premiere here. And the fact he went through and did that is just, yeah, it's important.
Awesome. So I quickly want to touch on, we had more than, you know, 6 African artists on the soundtrack of this film, right? What did it take to get all of that infused into the
There are loads of African artists on the soundtrack. You have, you know, Bloody Civilian, Rama, Fireboy, CK, Thames, Busiswa, Dab and Gogo, like so many artists and producers behind the scenes, and a whole team of Africans that worked with Ludwig and Ryan to bring this soundtrack together. Obviously, like, you know, logistically it was tough, but it really all came through, and now it's amazing.
So I wanted to ask, do you think this is much more or less like a marketing play, you know, to get the African audiences interested in the project, or it was just, you know, we need to get Africans on this project? What do you think?
I don't think it was about marketing. I think Ludwig and Ryan, like Ludwig, the composer of the movie, and Ryan, the director, everything they make is from their heart. And, you know, even speaking to them, this is the soundtrack they wanted to make for this movie. I don't think it's about marketing. I think it's just a creative move. And it's amazing that people also like the music. No woman, no cry. Little darling, don't shed no tear. No woman, no cry. It's just like, you know, the fact that Ludwig and Ryan flew down to Lagos, stayed in Lagos 10 days, like, people didn't really know what was happening. Like, we'd go out one or two times and people would see us and be like, isn't that Ludwig? Isn't that Ryan? But no, that was like a really amazing time. And the fact we did it in Lagos, you know, they could have just said, oh, all of these artists come to LA, come to New York, or send us verses. But they came here to like live that experience. And
so I wanted to ask you, doing like a comparison between the music industry and the film industry in Nigeria, what do you think each should be learning from each industry? Because again, right, music has sort of like gone international. You're seeing international collaborations, of course, like this. What do you think the film industry should be doing to get this right?
I feel like the music industry here is very collaborative, and the film industry can learn a bit from that. It seems a bit monopolized sometimes, and I think the film industry can learn from that. But the film industry, all the entertainment sectors in Nigeria work together, even if they don't mean to. They all work together to push the movement forward. But I think working on this movie and seeing the synergy between the music world and the film world, there's a lot we can learn, and there's a lot I have learned.
I wanted to ask, you know, the first time we're seeing the Black Panther Wakanda sequel, it was a Thames cover, and it moved everybody because there was such an emotional impact in the song. I wanted to get, is there like a mechanism or like a framework of how that happened behind the scenes?
That was the first day of recording, the day Ludwig and Ryan landed in Lagos. Yeah, Thames had like, obviously she had a crazy schedule, she could only come in that night. And when she recorded that song, like, I personally was close to tears. Like, that was, I mean, she's one of my favorite artists, one of a good friend of mine, but seeing her record that, like, it was really emotional. And to hear that on like the first trailer as well, like, it's perfect.
Final question. I wanted to ask you, in terms of the landscape of the African entertainment business, what do you think we should be doing more to be able to get this international wave of investments that are coming?
I don't think we need to be doing anything. We just need to keep making good music, good movies, good everything. I don't think we need to make people come here. They're here, you know? Yeah. Thank you.